So let's get started. So this is the fancy card, fancy fold card that I want to share with you today. What's really cool about this is you pull it open and look at that. I'm thinking of you. And you can push it in. And if it's in a regular sized card envelope, the back side is like this to cover up the mechanism. I'll show you how the mechanism works. So this is the card we're going to make. Unfortunately, I have run out of this design of the painted accents, fine art floral designer series paper. So I'm going to have to use a different design. And I think I left the paper. Oh, no, here we are. So for this project, still going to use Art Gallery. This is a beautiful stamp set, and happily it carries over. The designer series paper doesn't, much to my disappointment, but most designer series paper does not carry over, except for the one this time, the In Good Taste, and it's quite a thick stack of really nice backgrounds that are rocks or marbled effect, and there's a kind of a deft tile, a variety of different things that is with. So we're going to start with a piece of cardstock that is 5.5 by 8.5. I have scored it at 4.25. And I have also scored 1/4 inch off the end. That's along the end. We're going to be making an envelope. Now, you'll notice that this is not going to fold evenly. Oh, it didn't even. Oh, criminally. I almost said crap. Sorry. Anyway, it didn't score very straight. I'll see if I can straighten it out. I did it with my stamping trimmer, too. Come on. There, that is much better. Okay, so we're going to trim off this extra 1/4 inch. And for this kind of work, I like this. I like the stamp and trimmer rather than using a guillotine one, because you can measure 1/4 inches and hold it down very nicely. So now we have, it looks kind of like this, still kind of crooked. Maybe when I get it sealed, it'll work. You know how it goes. The practice one always works well, and then you go to do it, and you have problems. Go figure. To close this up now, I'm going to put tear and tape along. By the way, tear and tape is being carried over into the new catalog. It's just going to be, I think, a smaller roll. So you might want to stock up a little bit beforehand. Tear and tape there, and then across one end. One of the advantages of being a demonstrator is that you get to see the catalog first, and you get to order a pre-order of some of the products, not all of them, but some of them. And I just was notified that my pre-order has shipped. Oh, so exciting. It'll come next week. Oh, it won't get here until next week. but that's okay. I intend on my blog this month to feature some of the retiring stamp sets, because once they retire, it will be much harder for you guys who are not demonstrators to get a hold of them. So take off our mounting the paper cover. And when I get tired of messing with it, I get my take your pick. Which slides under it much easier than my finger does. Like that. This is a little bit wide, so I want to make sure that the tape on this edge is folded back on itself. Because you don't want to tape the inside down. Okay, now let's see if I can get this straight. It'd be easier to do it from this direction. There. Now I think I'll be able to smooth this out. Yes, much better. Okay, so we've got one end that's sealed, and we have one end that's open. And we have a piece of, this is 5-inch Whisper white or basic white cardstock, 5-inch by slightly under 4 inches, and it will be sliding into this pocket. And it's slightly big, so I'll trim down a little bit. Just a hair. Now it should fit in there. Slides in and out like that. I think I'll trim it down just a little bit more so it slides easier. And the other thing we have to do is we have to trim off a little bit off this end, because we want the card to stick out. So I'm going to cut. So it goes in, but leaves a little bit of an edge there. Okay, the next step is to put our designer series paper on the front. And I'm going to have to trim it down. So it measures 5 1/4, but I cut down the thing so it's gonna, now it's just exactly 5 1/4. So I'm going to make it 5 inches, and it was supposed to be 4 inches, which it is, but this ended up being 4 inches. So I will make this 3 3/4. And I have a second piece of the card of the designer series paper for the back. I'll make it 5 3 3/4. And I'll save this to put on the back later. Stamp and seal. That's kind of pretty. I kind of like that. I think perhaps maybe I'm going to use that side because I haven't been too fond of this gray background. Okay, now I'm going to put the card inside. I'm going to slide it in to where it has just a touch like that. See? Out. And I'm going to punch a hole through all three layers. I'm pulling out my trusty crocodile. You can use a handheld punch. 1/4 inch probably would be best. Just put it in about. Back out here. And center it and punch a hole. Okay. So now you've got a hole through both sides of that and this. And the trick is you turn this card around, put it back in, and line up the holes like that. First, you need ribbon, and you need enough that it will go give you room to tie a nice bow, and it's going to wrap pretty much all the way around the card. This ribbon is one of my favorites, and it is also retiring, this one, and also the gold metal edged. And they didn't provide anything to replace it. It's like, oh no. But I'm sure I'll find some other thing. I like about this was it was easy to dye with blends to give you, or even markers to give you whatever color you wanted. Okay, and then you thread the ribbon through the hole through all three layers. Bring it up. You're going to tie a bow up here. Before I tie the bow, I am going to write with a pen to pull. You could do a tag or something like that if you wanted to that says pull, but I'm just going to write right here, pull. And I'm doing it before I tie the bow because then the bow isn't in the way. And one of the little tricks that I have found that I love is I always have a challenge getting this ribbon to be tight enough but not too tight. And when I go to make my bow, it usually ends up getting the thing too loose. So I put a glue dot where I want my knot to be. And I'll make my first knot. I think it'll get a little more even. And press it into that glue dot. Now my hands are free to make my bow. You can do this with baker's twine, any kind of ribbon. And there, have a nice bow. And this is the way it works. You slide it in, not slide. Now that glue is going to cause problems. A little bit of sticky that I had along the edge. Okay, so see how the ribbon just slides. Isn't that something? And then when you go to open it, it goes that way. I love it. It's so much fun. Okay, so I want it to look like, I want the bow, the ribbon to go all the way across. So I'm going to take some more. Oh, that was the end of my ribbon. I think, but that'll be plenty. Because I'm going to cover the back with that other piece of designer series paper. So I'm going to just run the stamp and seal along the ribbon. It would be better if I had done this with craft sheet and just put it over like this. And it's going to be on the back. Okay, so now we can cover that all up, the mechanism all up. Because you see, that doesn't affect. See, it still slides. So I'm going to put this on the back and making sure not to put any stamp and seal along here so that it doesn't mess up the mechanism. Still pulls. And that hides the back. So we've got to have to do something about this. And we're going to make this thing. I forgot to cut this, so I'll go get some more Whisper White and the dye, and we'll do it with my trusty mini Stampin' Emboss machine. Yay! So I'll be right back. The dye I'm using is from the Stitch So Sweetly set of dyes. And it is, I believe, the third out from the smallest. Nope. It's the third in from the largest. So it's this one here. By the way, I don't think I've mentioned before, but the way I store my dies is this is the cardboard that the dies come on, but I hate pulling it off the the double-sided tape that they put on there. So I take a piece of adhesive magnetic thing that I buy at Amazon, and I put it on the card, and then I have taken to cutting the label so that it just fits the piece of the cardstock and right when the die came out and how much it was and what bundle it was a part of, so that when I go to sell it, I have all that information right there. And I just slide it in. But I have found that with the way they close it like this, it sometimes catches the dies. So I actually turn the dies over and have them on the smooth side, and then the paper side, it's easy to close it. So that's how I store my dies. Now this will go over here like that to cover up the mechanism. And I'll be putting it on Stampin' Dimensionals. But before we do that, we have to do the flowers. And I could have gone ahead with these now that I see that, but I had planned to use the other side, the Designer Series paper. So I have pre-stamped the flowers. This is Mango Melody. And since the color of the Designer Series paper had the shaded spruce, I stamped the leaves that way. And you wonder, how in the world do you get the same color? I tried coloring directly onto the photopolymer stamp, and it did not work very well at all. So I stamped and I stamped in the two colors. And you notice I didn't stamp the whole thing. I don't need to, because I'm only going to use this part of it. Oh, got to get those dies. And because I don't have a magnetic platform, I'm going to get a piece of washi tape to help hold the die down. Thank you. so that it doesn't shift. It still did. And then I'll cut out the leaf part. Wasn't too bad. Didn't shift too bad. Hi, guys. Going to cut the leaf off of the yellow. Like that. And then we layer it. On top. We'll do a little bit of coloring. To color the stems that were yellow. And I want a little bit of color variation because the designer series paper had kind of red poppy, or poppy red, rather, I should say. So I'm going to color these buds that color. And the flowers had a little bit streaks of the poppy red in them, so I'm going to add a little bit of that. For a little bit of variation and depth interest. and use some of the multi-purpose liquid glue. Layered on top. Ta-da! Magical. Okay, so this card probably will get mailed out, and I could have used Stampin' Dimensionals on it there to make a little more depth and interest, but I'm already going to have Stampin' Dimensionals on here. So I'm just going to put this on with liquid glue. A few drops. That. If you wanted, you could stamp down here a greeting of some sort. Actually, the layering of the two pieces actually makes it for a bit of dimension anyway. We'll put Stampin' Dimensionals on the corners. Put it right over that mechanism, like that. And you can still pull it out, push it in, like that. So there's the card, finished for that. But you want to perhaps put a greeting, at least I do. So I'm going to stamp "I'm Thinking of You" from the stamp set. Up above here. Or I could say, "You are lovely. I'm thinking of you. Congratulations. Thank you. Best wishes." But I am making this to send to some of our care team people that we've been calling for this whole long year plus now of isolation. So I will be sending this to them. There, I'm thinking of you. Got some ink on the ribbon. Oh, well, that makes a little bit of a design for the ribbon. Ties it in with the card. So there you have it. An easy, cute, interactive card. Thank you for what. Oh, before you go, I have to show you. Look at this. The new annual catalog has come. So if you want one and you don't have a demonstrator already, contact me and I'll be happy to send you one be your demonstrator to help you with your crafting needs, whatever your questions are, stuff like that. The dimensions for this will be on my blog, as well as you can see it on my YouTube channel. If you have any questions, email me, sue@soggystamper.com. My blog is www.soggystamper.com. And if you need any of these products, stop by my store, my online store, Creations by Sue, stampinup.net. So thank you for watching, come back again next week. I'll have another fun card to demonstrate to you. So have a wonderful afternoon, and happy Easter. See you all later.